let customers know about this bill and know about what's at stake here.
Janine, are a lot of the customers that we're talking about, and especially with your two organizations, essentially captive customers, customers that couldn't switch to wireless anyhow because they couldn't afford it? They would have that, not have that option?
You have a, it's a diverse group. Some of those customers would fit in that category. But you may also have customers who are middle income and just want the basic service. You know, my mother's never going to get a cell phone. You know, she's going to stick to her landline. She's a middle income senior. There are a lot of people in that kind of category as well, but it's very true that for a lot of people who are low-income customers, this is an affordable service. They're not eligible for Lifeline, and this is the service that's at risk for them. And in today's, you know, day and age, telephone service is a necessity, and we should not lose sight of that. That having that ability to communicate with the outside world, especially if you're shut in, is, you know, or you're a senior, you're disabled, you're a mother with a new child who's home alone during the day. Any number of circumstances creates that need to be able to have a link to the telephone in the outside world.
When you say you don't believe the rationale that the industry is saying the reason for this bill, why do you believe this bill is getting significant hearings in both houses?
Well, I think that right now with the state of the economy in Ohio, legislators are looking for opportunities to increase economic development, and the utilities are saying if you do this, there will be increases in economic development. And I think that they're hoping that that will in fact be the case.
That would be
my best guess.
Have you been given a timeline at all by the committees on opponent testimony, and have you heard anything from the PUCO? Support, non-support, where they stand on this bill? I know you can't speak for them, but...
Yeah, that's going to be my answer.
Yeah, okay.
But we'll have to talk to the PCO about their position on it. But we have not been given a timeline for opponent testimony. We are certainly looking forward to that opportunity to testify. We are in the process of setting up meetings. We've had meetings with a number of legislators. We have had meetings with some of the leadership, and we have meetings scheduled. Our perception is that leadership wants to do this a good careful look and do it again.
How many people have Lifeline services?
Do we know them?
I don't know.
Is that something we can provide? We'll provide that. We'll get that to you.
Islands have an option basically at the competitive markets for landline service, and this would increase competition and potentially decrease rates and improve service.
First of all, I would dispute that number that 95% of Ohioans have other options. I've heard that number as well. So we don't agree with that number. All you have to do is drive around the state of Ohio, and you will find huge pockets of areas where you can't get cell phone service, where broadband is non-existent. And I would say it's more than 5% of the state of Ohio. So we dispute that. The other thing is, you know, you have the definition of what is a competitive service. And the utility companies are using their definition, cellular service or bundle packages of service. What we're talking about here is just basic service, just a dial phone. Service that you can get at AT&T for $14.25 per month. Tell me the cell phone service that you can find or any other service that's comparable to $14.25 a month. There really is not a comparable service available at this time, and that's why it's so important to preserve this service for working families that need to have access to the outside world.
Deregulation of the telecommunications industry?
Right now, we have that in place in current law. What we have is a law that says, utility company, if you want to provide deregulated service in an area, come in and make a demonstration that there is competition in your service area, and we will let you go, and you can be deregulated. So the only obstacle to deregulation right now are in the areas where there is no competition. So if we change that, what we end up with is deregulated monopolies. There are two ways that you protect consumers. One is through a robust marketplace. And I love it when I hear an ad on the TV where they said, if you find a lower rate somewhere else, you come down to my store and I'll match your price. That's competition. That's a robust market. That's what we would like to see. But if you don't have that, then you need regulation to protect consumers from unbridled rate increases when there are no other alternatives. So that's really the part that's really problematic here.